रजन, एक बार बताइयो कि आवाज आ रही क्या? डॉक लिंक जो है वो डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में, तो वहां से ले लो। अच्छा, तो 2-3 मिनट और वेट कर रहे हैं, फिर स्टार्ट करते हैं। So can you please explain the point x and y problem again? जो एड कोडर का क्वेश्चन दिया था वो पूछ रहे हैं, फिर पॉइंट्स जो उसने स्ट्रक जो रजन ने स्ट्रक्चर स्ट्रक्ट का बताया वो पूछ रहे हैं। अच्छा, तो वैसे ठीक है, वो भी बता देंगे स्ट्रक्ट वाला। वैसे जो क्वेश्चन था जो लास्ट लास्ट में दिया था, बिल्कुल ट्राई किया किसी ने? नहीं वैसे? ओके, अच्छा किया, ठीक है। तो सॉल्व किसी ने किया, किसी का एक्सेप्टेड सबमिट किया हो तो एक्सेप्ट हुआ सॉल्यूशन। अच्छा एन स्क्वायर में ट्राई किया होगा सेक्शन, तूने मैसेज भी किया था तो एन स्क्वायर वाला मैंने कल ही बता दिया था कि नहीं चलेगा, तो ठीक है कोई बात नहीं। अच्छा एटलीस्ट ट्राई किया। और किसी का हुआ मतलब सॉल्व किया किसी ने, मतलब किसी ने सबमिट किया और मतलब एसी दिखाया हो कि मतलब एक्सेप्ट हो गया। बाकी किसी ने ट्राई नहीं किया क्या मतलब ऐसे? कैन यू प्लीज एक्सप्लेन पेयर वंस अगेन? ठीक है मैं क्वेश्चन उसका सोल्यूशन बताऊंगा तो उससे क्लियर हो जाएगा। ठीक है बाकी क्वेश्चन किस किस ने ट्राई किया सबमिट नहीं किया, कोई इसके लिए पढ़ने लग गया था। अच्छा नहीं हुआ सर, ओके फाइन। सो ठीक है टाइम हो गया तो स्टार्ट करते हैं। तो क्वेश्चन तो सबने पढ़ लिया है, मतलब समझ तो आ गया होगा, ठीक है किसी को क्वेश्चन में तो डाउट नहीं है, स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड क्वेश्चन है। ओके तो इतना डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन नहीं है जितना देखने से लग रहा है। ठीक है तो सोल्यूशन बताऊंगा, सोल्यूशन के बाद तुम्हें लगेगा कि अच्छा सिर्फ यही करना था। ओके तो ठीक है क्वेश्चन ये है कि मेरे पास एन टाउन्स हैं, ठीक है दो, हर टाउन के साथ एसोसिएटेड दो वैल्यूज हैं, ठीक है ए आई और बी आई। ए आई तुम्हारे प्रो ओ की वोटर्स है और बी आई तुम्हारे प्रो ताकाशी वोटर्स है, ठीक है और कोई वोटर्स नहीं है। तो ये ताकाशी जो है वो किसी भी टाउन में जाके स्पीच दे सकता है, कैन मेक अ स्पीच इन ईच टाउन, मतलब किसी भी टाउन में जाके वो मतलब कितनी मर्जी टाउन में जाके वो स्पीच दे सकता है। ठीक है तो इफ ही मेक सेंस, तो अगर वो कहीं किसी टाउन में जाके स्पीच देता है, ठीक है तो ऑल वोटर्स इन दैट टाउन मतलब ए आई एंड बी आई दोनों जो है वो उसके लिए वोट करेंगे, ए आई प्लस बी आई वोट्स, ठीक है इतने टोटल वोट्स हैं उस टाउन के, वो सारे वोट्स ताकाशी को जाएंगे। ठीक है ऑन दी अदर हैंड अगर वो स्पीच नहीं देता किसी भी टाउन में तो उस टाउन में जो वोटर्स हैं प्रो ओके वोटर्स हैं वो ओके के लिए वोट करेंगे एंड दूसरे वाले जो वोटर्स हैं जो बी आई है वो वोट ही नहीं करेंगे। ठीक है तो टू गेट मोर वोट्स देन ओके, अब ठीक है अब हमें सेकेंड वाले बंदे को जिताना है। ठीक है हाउ मैनी टाउन्स जस्ट दस ताकाशी नीड टू मेक स्पीचेज एटलीस्ट, ठीक है तो हमें मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ टाउन्स निकालने सच दैट क्या कहते हैं ताकाशी के वोट्स स्ट्रिक्टली ग्रेटर होने हैं। ठीक है मतलब इक्वल नहीं होने चाहिए, स्ट्रिक्टली ग्रेटर होने हैं। ठीक है तो ये कंस्ट्रेंट्स गिवन है तुमको, एक मिनट। ठीक है ठीक है तो देखते हैं कैसे सॉल्व होगा फिर। अच्छा तो इसमें इट्स अ गुड थिंग, मतलब बेटर रहेगा कि अगर हम जो AI जो एरे बनाएंगे एन साइज की या पेयर की एरे बनाएंगे, ठीक है उसमें हम लॉन्ग लॉन्ग लेके चलें क्योंकि हमें वोट्स ऐड करने होंगे। ठीक है अब 10 to the power 9 वोट्स अगर 10 to the power 5 सिटीज़ में होगा तो तुम्हें मतलब 10 to the power 14 तक जा सकता है। तो इससे हर जगह लॉन्ग लॉन्ग लिखने से अच्छा है ऊपर डिफाइन कर ले। ठीक तो नीचे यहीं पे सबमिट करता हूँ। ठीक है अगर और जूम कर लो तो बता देना, ठीक है मेरे ख्याल से विजिबल होगा। ठीक तो ऊपर ही डिफाइन कर लो। कंपाइलर में कर लेता हूँ, उसे ये रहेगा। सो ये ऊपर हैश डिफाइन तो बता दिया था कि तुम किसी को भी शॉर्ट में लिखने के लिए ऐसे लिख सकते हो, है ना। तो मैंने हैश डिफाइन इंट लिख रखा है, ठीक। और पुश बैक को मैंने पीबी में कर रखा, मतलब बेसिकली कोड फास्ट लिखने के लिए कि इसे पुश बैक और ये फर्स्ट सेकेंड ये सब बार बार बड़े बड़े ना लिखने पड़े, मैंने उनको शॉर्ट में ऐसे डिफाइन कर रखा है। तो तुम भी अपने हिसाब से मतलब कर सकते हो, ठीक है, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है उसमें। तो और ये हटा देता हूँ, चलो कोई नहीं, ठीक है। अच्छा सुन, ठीक है, ओके। सो फर्स्ट इनपुट इज एन, नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स, ठीक है। एंड उसके बाद आप तुम पेयर बना सकते हो, पेयर मतलब पेयर की एरे बना सकते हो, ठीक है। पी आई आई एस, या फिर ये हटा दो अभी, अगर कंफ्यूजन हो तो, कंफ्यूजन होगी तो मैंने सिर्फ लॉन्ग लॉन्ग डिफाइन किया ऊपर, ठीक है, और कुछ डिफाइन नहीं किया, बाकी सब ठीक सही से लिख देता हूँ। तो यही है कि देखो अभी मैं पी आई आई लिखा था तो वो छोटा था, काफी जल्दी लिख सकता था। तो अब पेयर इंट इंट बार बार लिखना पड़ेगा, सर इंट 32T, क्योंकि मैंने ये बताया था हमने कि जब एस डिफाइन करते हैं या तो तुम यहाँ पे लॉन्ग लॉन्ग करो, ठीक है, लॉन्ग लॉन्ग करोगे तो इसको करने की जरूरत नहीं है, तुम यहाँ पे ऐसे रख सकते हो, ठीक है। पर अगर तुम इंट को लॉन्ग लॉन्ग कर दोगे, ठीक है, तो इसका मतलब क्या हो जाएगा, इंट का मतलब लॉन्ग लॉन्ग मेन फंक्शन हो जाएगा, मतलब उसका रिटर्न टाइप इंट नहीं होगा, लॉन्ग हो जाएगा। तो वो नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि हमारे कोड में एक फंक्शन जरूर होना चाहिए जिसका रिटर्न टाइप इंट हो, ठीक है। तो इसलिए इंट 32T इज ऑल्सो इंट ओनली, ठीक है, मतलब इंट 32 बिट्स, मतलब 32 बिट्स का नंबर, एंड इंट इज ऑल्सो 32 बिट्स, तो वही चीज़ है, ठीक है। तो आई थिंक अब क्लियर हो गया होगा। तो तुम्हें अगर नहीं करना है ऐसा, तुम्हें अगर मतलब सिर्फ इंट लिखना है और हैश डिफाइन भी यूज़ करना है तो इसको एलएल कर सकते हो। मैं एलएल नहीं करता, मैं इंट ही करता हूँ, आदत बन गई है। तो तुम लोग अपने हिसाब से कर सकते हो, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, ठीक है। तो अब इनपुट ले लेते हैं, तो ai.first ai.second, ठीक है। तो ai.first सर एक लूप बना लेंगे और कंटिन्यू कर लेंगे जब तक सम ऑफ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ एरे इन पेयर टू, नहीं भाई ऐसे नहीं होगा, मतलब क्या कहते हैं, मतलब इतना नहीं है ऐसा, थोड़ा सोचना, मतलब सोल्यूशन देख लिया, मतलब ट्राई किया होगा, सबमिट किया होगा, तो अगर एक्सेप्ट हुआ तो ठीक है, नहीं तो फिर मतलब गलत है कुछ, ठीक है। तो मैंने जैसे किया था वो मैं बता देता हूँ, ठीक है। तो ठीक है, अब एन सिटीज है, ठीक है। तो अब अगर तो एज्यूम, तो ऐसे दो हम वो बना सकते हैं, ठीक है, दो वेरिएबल्स हैं, ठीक है। तो मैं डिक्लेयर कर रहा हूँ, यहाँ पे लिख रहा हूँ कि एक्स और वाई क्या सिग्निफाई कर रहे हैं। एक्स इज बंदे का नाम क्या था, ओकीज वुड्स, एंड ताकाहाशी, ठीक है, मतलब ये वोट्स है दोनों के, मतलब इनिशियली जीरो है, मतलब मैं मान रहा हूँ कि अभी जीरो है, ठीक है। तो अगर तुम क्या कहते हैं, किसी भी सिटी में जाके वोट नहीं करते, ठीक है, मतलब अगर किसी भी सिटी में जाके ताकाशी स्पीच नहीं देता, तो तुम्हारी वाई की वैल्यू क्या होगी, एक बार बता दो जरा। ये तो मतलब आई थिंक समझ कर सकते हो तुम कि वाई की वैल्यू क्या होगी अगर वो किसी भी सिटी में जाके वोट ना दे, वो स्पीच ना दे, जीरो, फाइन, या तो वाई जीरो होगा, ठीक है। और एक्स की वैल्यू क्या होगी अगर वो कहीं भी जाके वोट स्पीच नहीं देगा, तो एक्स की वैल्यू, अब एक्स की वैल्यू मतलब अगर ताकाहाशी कहीं भी जाके स्पीच ना दे तो एक्स की वैल्यू क्या होगी, मतलब ओकी के कितने वोट्स होंगे। सर वोट्स को अनसाइंड लेंगे तो ज़्यादा अच्छा होगा ना, सम एआई डॉट फर्स्ट सम, ओके, हाँ सही है, ठीक है, सम ऑफ वोट्स ऑफ ओकी, ठीक है, तो वो पहले वाला होगा, एआई डॉट फर्स्ट होगा, ठीक है, मतलब ए डॉट फर्स्ट वाले जितने भी मतलब है नंबर्स उनको ऐड कर देंगे तो वो तुम्हारे ओके के वोट्स हो जाएंगे, है ना, ठीक। तो पहले मैं मान रहा हूँ कि ताकाहाशी ने कहीं भी जाके स्पीच नहीं दी, तो ठीक है, वाई जाहिर है जीरो है जैसे तुमने बोला, और एक्स जो है तुम्हारा उसमें फर्स्ट वाला ऐड हो जाएगा, है ना, तो ये क्लियर हुआ, ये तो ठीक है, सबने आंसर दे दिया, तो ठीक है, आई थिंक क्लियर है। एआई का सम, अच्छा एआई यहाँ पे दो एलिमेंट सही है, कि भी एक फर्स्ट है और एक सेकेंड है, तो वो भी स्पेसिफाई करना अगली बार से, ठीक है, ठीक है। तो आई थिंक ये क्लियर है सबको कि वाई जीरो है और एक्स के कुछ वोट्स हैं, ठीक है। अब हमें वाई को बढ़ाना है और एक्स को घटाना है, ठीक है, अगर किसी भी सिटी में जाके अच्छा ठीक है, मान लो कि ठीक है, मतलब एक्स और वाई की तुम्हारे पास वैल्यूज हैं, अब मान लो कि एक सिटी है, ठीक है, जिसकी वैल्यूज ए और बी है सपोज, ठीक है, मतलब जैसे तुम्हारे पास सपोज कोई पर्टिकुलर आई है जिसका फर्स्ट जो है वो ए है, मान लो सपोज, मतलब ये कुछ कोड नहीं है, ये मैं वैसे ही वेरिएबल में ज्यूम कर रहा हूँ, ठीक है, और ए आई डॉट सेकेंड जो है वो तुम्हारा बी है, ठीक है, जो जैसे क्वेश्चन में गिवन है, ठीक है। तो अगर मैं इस आई आईएथ सिटी में जाके स्पीच देता हूँ, ठीक है, तो वाई की कितनी वैल्यू बढ़ जाएगी, कोई बताओ जरा, अगर मैं आईएथ सिटी में जाके स्पीच दे रहा हूँ तो, और मेरे पास ये पता है कि प्रो ओकी वोटर्स और प्रो ताकाशी वोटर्स ए एंड बी रिस्पेक्टिवली, ठीक है, तो ए प्लस बी, हाँ सही है, ठीक है। तो अगर तुम मतलब किसी, अगर वो किसी भी सिटी में जाके स्पीच दे देगा तो ए प्लस बी उसके वोट्स बढ़ जाएंगे, सही है, बिल्कुल सही है, ठीक है, एक्स में ए प्लस बी बढ़ जाएगा, सही है। अब और वाई कितना कम, और सॉरी वाई वाई बढ़ जाएगा इतना, ठीक है, ताकाशी के ताकाशी का वाई है, ठीक है, तो वाई बढ़ जाएगा, ठीक है, और एक्स कितना कम हो जाएगा, माइनस से, हाँ सही है, सेम, ठीक है, ये भी सही है। तो इफेक्टिवली उन दोनों के बीच का जो डिफरेंस है, ठीक है, मतलब एक्स और वाई में कुछ डिफरेंस था, जाहिर है कि हम एक्स अभी बड़ा है, मान लो एक्स अभी बड़ा है, वाई छोटा है, वाई को हमने बढ़ाना है, तो इफेक्टिवली डिफरेंस कितना कम हो रहा है उनका, मतलब उनके बीच का जो डिफरेंस है वो कितना कम हो रहा है। लिखो जरा, 2a+b, सही है, हाँ 2a नहीं, 2a+b डिवीजन, ठीक है, क्योंकि ऐसे समझो कि x कुछ है, मतलब ये नंबर लाइन समझ लो, और ये x है, x बड़ा है, ठीक है, y भी बड़ा है, y बड़ा है, y है, तो y इस तरफ जा रहा है a प्लस बी से, और x इस तरफ जा रहा है, क्या कहते हैं, एक्स इस तरफ जा रहा है ए से, तो इफेक्टिवली डिफरेंस तो ए इतना काम हो रहा है ना, ए टू ए प्लस बी का है ना, तो आई थिंक अब किसी को क्लियर है कि जिसने, ठीक है नहीं, मतलब मेहुल और दीवी शायद तुमने कुछ और लिखा था, तो कैसे हो रहा है ये समझ लो, मतलब अगर ये समझ लोगे तो क्वेश्चन हो जाएगा। एक बार लिख दो, यस नो, हाँ ठीक है, तो ठीक है, तो मतलब अब तो ठीक है, अब क्वेश्चन रह ही नहीं गया कुछ, ठीक है, तो मतलब अगर तुम एक सिटी लेते हो तो जो तुम्हारा डिफरेंस है वो 2a प्लस बी से कम हो जाएगा, मतलब उसकी वैल्यू उतनी कम हो जाएगी, ठीक है। अब कौन, तो फिर सिटी कौन सी सिलेक्ट करनी चाहिए तुम्हारे अकॉर्डिंग, मतलब जिसकी 2a प्लस बी की वैल्यू जो है, मतलब 2ai डॉट फर्स्ट प्लस ai डॉट सेकेंड, वो तुम्हारी सबसे ज़्यादा है, तो जिसकी सब वैल्यू वो सबसे ज़्यादा होगी वो सिलेक्ट करनी चाहिए पहले, क्योंकि उससे जो है डिफरेंस सबसे ज़्यादा कम होगा। ये क्लियर है ना आपको, एक बार लिख दो यस नो, क्योंकि यही इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है। हाँ ठीक है, सही है। तो इसमें करना क्या है, पेयर्स को हल्का सा चेंज करना है, जैसे ठीक, तो इसमें तो मैं फर्स्ट वाले पेयर को, मतलब टेम्प में, अच्छा मैं बता देता हूँ कि क्या कर रहा हूँ मैं, एक मिनट दो मिनट, तो सो प्लीज टेल मी, ओके फाइन, सो ए आई डॉट फर्स्ट दैट शुड बी टू इंटू ए आई डॉट फर्स्ट प्लस ए आई डॉट सेकेंड, ठीक, एंड योर ए आई डॉट सेकेंड इज इक्वल टू टेम। अब बेसिकली इसके बाद जो तुम्हारा पेयर है वो उसमें ए प्लस बी, अब पेयर जो है वो ए प्लस बी और सॉरी टू ए प्लस बी और ए का बन गया है। ये क्लियर है सबको कि मैंने क्या, ओके इंग्लिश में, ठीक है, तो सो इज दिस ऑल राइट दैट व्हाट दिस फ्रॉम दिस दिस फ्रॉम दिस लूप व्हाट आई हैव डन, आई हैव सिंपली यू नो मेड द पेयर वाज ए कॉमा बी, सो इन द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट आई मल्टीप्लाइड इट विद टू एंड आई एडेड द सेकेंड एलिमेंट, सो दैट्स दैट मेक्स इट टू ए प्लस बी, and the second element I assigned it to the first one, I assigned a temp variable here, so that makes it 2a plus b and a, okay, so this is the pair we have now, okay, so now if we use the sort function, right, so it will sort according to, first it will see the 2a plus b value, fine, and then if two elements, if two towns have the same value of 2a plus b, then it will compare the a value. So this is how the sort function will go on a array of pairs. Okay, so we can do that as well. Just sort it a comma a plus n. Okay, and this is it. Okay, this fine. So after this sort, we have the element, we have the town sorted according to this pair, according for primary according to the 2a plus b value, and if the two values of some towns are same, then it will compare the a value, okay, so this is how the sort function works on the pairs, okay, it will first compare the first value and then the second value. So can you tell me the index with the maximum 2a plus b value? Zero. Okay. See, the thing is, the sort function always by default works in sorts it in ascending order, right? So, yeah, n minus 1. Fine. Say. So, I think you can guess that first it's optimal to select the city n minus 1, right? The city whose position is now at n minus 1. I think that's clear now. It would be optimal to first select that city because the 2a plus b value is greater for it. So if you select that, the difference is going to decrease by the most largest value. So how we can implement it? So suppose we need, so the answer is 0 because we haven't given, because he hasn't given speech in any of the cities yet. And let's have an index equal to n minus 1 representing that this is the most optimal city we have, like the value with the 2a plus the value the town with the maximum 2a plus b value. Okay, and what should be the condition? The condition should be y x is greater than equal to y. As soon as this condition gets false, we have our value y which would be greater than x. So this condition should be clear, like while loop condition, right? That why I am doing this, right? Because this is what we need to do. We need to make the y greater than x. So while this condition, while x is greater than y, we'll have to select one city is equal to necessary. Yes, this is necessary because we need to make his vote strictly greater than the other one's vote. So even if they are equal, we still will have to select one city. So yes, that's necessary. And there will always exist a solution, okay? Because even if you select all the cities, like even if he decides to give a speech in all the cities, in that case the votes of the second person would be equal to zero, and thus other person would have some votes. So the condition, so there would always be an answer. Okay, so in this case what we'll have to do is we just need to increase the answer. That means we are currently that means the current ith value we are we are giving the speech in that. So in that case x would, as you said, so x would, wait a second, let's do with y first. So y would increase by, so now we have the pair 2a plus b comma b, we don't have the pair a comma b. So and y is going to increase by a plus b. So a plus b you can write as 2a plus b minus a. So that's the first, so that could be ai dot first minus ai dot second, and y would decrease by the second, that's y would decrease by the value a. So a we have stored in the second index, a second element. So you can just do ai dot second and can decrease my I. That means that you have used the current I value, and when the next iteration comes, like if the value x is still greater than equal to y, in that case we'll select the next I in decreasing order. Is this, we are selecting only one city or many cities? We can select many cities. That's what we have to find. We have to find the minimum number of cities which will make the vote of the second person more than the first person. So this is the code, and you can just output it and I'll just run to show you. So okay, so this is the input. So you can see that's the input. 4212251113, and the output is 1, right? We just need one city. You can also see the explanation after making the speech in the third town. Like you can see the third town has maximum value of 2a plus b. Okay, so that's why we are selecting it. And we can have one more input like this. And so yeah, that's coming 3, because if you select just one city, now all the values are same. Okay, so there's no difference whether you select the first or second. So suppose I select only one city, so in that case the other person will have votes 1 2 3 4 4 into 2 8 votes, while the second person will have 3 votes. So we still need to select one more city. So if we select one more, so the other person is going to have 6 votes, and The second person is also going to have 6 votes. So now they are equal, but we don't want equal. We want the second person to win. So we'll select one more city. Okay. So I think it's clear. I think the logic is clear. Because so what was the need of redefining our pair? Like, see, the thing is, like I explained, like if you have understood that you need the city with the maximum 2a plus b value, so that means you will have to sort according to that variable only, not any other variable. Like if you don't redefine your pair, then and if you apply the sort function, then it will sort according to the pair a comma b. First it will compare the a values, then it will compare the b values. So are there any sorting methods which we have the time complexity less than n scale? Okay, n log n is the best time complexity you get of a sorting algorithm. There's one something called as counting sort as well, but it has some condition. It cannot work in all the situations. It has an order of n solution, but it has some limit on the values that can be present in an array. So yes, the sorting algorithm is n log n. So what is the time complexity of this code which I have written? So explain sort again. Okay, so is that clear that if you select one city with values a comma b, then your difference of votes will decrease by 2a plus b. Vivek, you can reply that. I do that. Yes, okay. So that means we'll have to sort the cities according to the value of 2a plus b. Is that right? See? Okay, so that means we'll have to sort the value, we have to select the value with greatest 2a plus b value. Fine, so that you can do. So if that is the first element in the pair, first limit of the pair, then that's by default. Like the if you sort a pair array, it will sort first according to the first value, and after that, if the first values of any two elements are same, it is going to sort according to the second value. So we need 2a plus b in the first, and you can see that we need an a because the value of the first person is decreasing by a, and the value of the second person is increasing by a plus b, and a plus b we can get by subtracting a from 2a plus b. So that's why I have created the second element as a. So I think it's clear now. N log n, yeah, n log n. And what is the time complexity of this while loop? Yeah, so it's n basically. So basically I, so now the condition, you cannot see from the condition what's the time complexity, but you can see that you at most you can select I n times, right? There are n cities, so the time complexity would be order of n, right? So if you see that now, if you think about this, you will find that the question is not difficult, right? The question was easy, like you just have to sort and you just have to apply, you know, just do this. This is like four lines, right? So question was easy, I think. So this is how you can solve it, like sort according to something, and sort of pair A is the initial iterator. Yes, is you can say that A is basically an reference, basically an array. When you create an array, it's a reference, basically reference to the first element or something. So A comma, so A is the first one, and like Rajan told in the last class, like a dot begin and a dot end, it's similar to that in array as well. So yeah, so now after seeing the solution, who thinks that the question was difficult? I think no one was able to solve it yesterday among you guys, so I think you found it difficult. But I think now if you see the solution, you think that yeah, the question was easy. So I'll just paste it. रिप्लाई तो कर दे यार कोई, मतलब पूछा था. ओके तो आगे लेजन विल कंटिन्यू. ओके
So today, is it clear to all of you, my voice? So is it better than yesterday or it's the same? Yeah, I know I'm audible, but is it better than yesterday? Okay, it's fine, it's better. Okay, so so we have started in yesterday class C++ STL. So the full form of STL is the standard template library. In the standard template library, we are given some, you know, kind of containers to store our data. For example, we have discussed about vector in the last two classes. So we have discussed vector. So vector is also a container. Container means a kind of data structures where we store our data. For example, in this problem we just Vikram discussed, so to store this information we have used a container, that is pair of int comma int, you know, a kind of array of pair. So it's a container. Yeah, and the next container which I am going to discuss is set. Okay, so is there anybody who knows something about set? What set actually is? Is there anybody? Mayank? Okay, no sir, it's fine, I will discuss. Okay, so let me discuss about set. So let me tell you how set works actually. For example, let's say this is your set. So initially your set is empty. So first let me discuss the syntax. So syntax, okay, so syntax is exactly same as vector. So just replace vector as a set, that is set of data type. Data type and set. Sorry, this is your set name. Whatever you feel like, you can give here. Okay. For example, if you want to define a set of integers, so you can write like this: set of integers, and the name. Let's say, for example, st. Okay. And for floating point numbers, set of float of st, for example, set of double st. So the syntax is exactly same as vector. So here means in case of vector we use vector over here, but right now we are using set. So the syntax is exactly similar. Now let me tell you what operations we have. So how set work actually. So so you can see the definition of set. Set is a special kind of STL container, a standard template library container, which stores unique elements in sorted order. For example, so we have defined an set of integers, for example, set of integer st, and let's say we have inferred a number that is 5, st dot inferred. So inferred is a function to, you know, to store the element in our set. In case of vector we used pushback function, but in case of set we use insert function to, you know, to push the element in a set. 5, 4. So now your set will look like 4, only 4, only one element. And in the second operation, for example, in the second operation we have push in sorry insert a number, let's say 3. So what set does actually, it doesn't happen like this 4 and 3. So in case of vector it will happen like this 4 then 3, but the important point in set is that it, you know, you can see from the definition itself, set is a special kind of STL container which stores unique elements in sorted order. So this should be in sorted form. So 3 will place at the first place. So 3 and 4, okay. And let's say in third operation we have insert a number 1. So what it will happen, so it will not like this 3 then 4 then 1. So it will not happen like this. It will look like this 1, 3, 4. It should be in sorted form always. After each and every operation it will be sorted. So this is the, you know, the basic rule of set actually, to, you know, to store the elements in sorted form. And this should be unique. So you can see here this is unique. For example, let's say I have pushed insert a number in the fourth operation as st dot inferred 3. So what will happen, it will not change at all. It will look like this 1, 3 and 4 because the elements should be unique in set. Yeah, so, unique. So just remember two things, unique and sorted order. Yeah. So we have so many functions in set. For example, in case of vector we have discussed pushback function, popback function, size function. So in set we also have so many functions. So the first function which I have discussed is insert, to insert the number, and to know the size function, and to get the size of the set we use size function. Size function in set. So int n. So to know the size of the set we use st dot size. Okay. So this is first of all my insert function in set. Then I have discussed size function in set. So is there any doubt till now? In set, that how set works, any small doubt? Yeah, I will discuss time complexity, don't worry, there are lots of them to discuss in set. Okay, I think there is no doubt. So now the time complexity of insert function is order of log n. So what happened here is that it set always store the element in a sorted form. So for example, by the way, we have we will discuss in next class, and you know, next to next class binary search, then it would be more clear that how the time complexity is log n. But right now just remember that the insertion process in set is log n, and how it happens we would discuss when we will be discussing binary search. So just right now remember that the time complexity of insertion in set is log n, and the time complexity of size function is order of 1. Because you guys don't know so many things, that's why we are not discussing right now. But we would cover in the next or next to next class. We may be discussing binary search. Okay, so we have discussed insertion, insert function, size of function. Now, there is one more term, that is a erase function. Erase function. Okay. Erase function in C plus in erase function in set. So what happens? For example, let's say you want to remove the element that is 3. Okay. So the syntax is like this: st dot erase. Just write that number 3. Okay. If so, there will be two cases. If the number is present. If the number is present, then it will remove it. It will remove it from the set. Now, if not, then nothing happens. So, if the element is not present in the set, so nothing happens actually. So we have discussed insert function, size function, erase function, and so there is one more important function. So there are lots of functions. So let me show you how many functions we have. So there is a site named C++ reference. Okay. So whenever you just forget any function in C++ STL, so you can go through this site, ENC CPS set. Okay. C++ reference, this is the site. So let me show you. Sorry, C++ reference. Yeah, so we have so see, there are lots of containers. We have array, dq, list, map, queue, set. So right now we are discussing set. Okay. And we have discussed vector. So these are some important STL which, you know, we would discuss in a code ISM class. So we have covered vectors. So right now we are at set. So in set, see, there are lots of functions. Begin, C end, C R, implace back, empty, end. So there are lots of functions, but you know, not all the function we use more often. So we use only you know, some functions. Like we use erase function, which I have discussed. We use size function. We use insert function. Okay. So there is one more important functions, that is empty. So to know whether the set is empty or not, so we use a, so the data type of the return value is boolean. Bool is empty equals to st dot empty. So if the set is empty, so it will return true value, and if the set is not empty, it will return false value. So it would be either true or it would be either false. Okay. So there are some more function, C begin, C in, but we never use it. Yeah. So there is one more important function, that is lower bound. But right now we would not going to discuss lower bound, because when we would discuss binary search, then we will discuss more about it, about lower bound, upper bound, binary search, and all this. So right now just remember these four important function, that is your you know, insert function, size function, erase function, and this empty function. So this is your definition of set, how set actually works, and these are some functions. Yeah. So is there any doubt in set till now? Vale 3 student, sir, please tell the time complexity of functions. Yeah, so I have discussed the time complexity of insert function is log n, size function is order of n. Yeah, sorry, the erase function also works in order of log n. So the time complexity of erase function is also order of log n. And the isEmpty function, this is your order of 1 constant. Yeah. So what happened behind the scene is that the structure of set is a tree like structure, because you guys don't know about tree a graph, these things. So that's why I'm not, we can't discuss more about it because you will not understand better it. That's why the behind the scene of set, it is stored the data in form of tree, a balancing tree that is known as AVL tree, a red black tree. So that's why we can't discuss about it, because it's a, it's a starting phase. No doubt, sir. I think there is no doubt. So let's proceed toward Mac. So I have one question for you. So just try it once. So the question is that you will be given n numbers, and after inserting each number, you have to print all the inserted numbers till now in sorted form. So tell me two way of doing this. So just try it once, take 2 minutes, just think about it, that how you can solve this problem. So you will be given n numbers, and after inserting each numbers, you have to print all the numbers till now in sorted form. For example, let's say I have inserted 1. So after inserting 1, your sorted form would look like only 1. So when we insert, for example, 2, so it should look like 1, 2. Okay, and let's say it's a 3, for example, it's a 3, so it should look like 1 and 3 in sorted form. Sorted means by default ascending order. So if we push insert 2, then it should look like 1, 2, 3. So just try it once, sir, how to print a set. So just tell me the way. Okay, so I will discuss how to how to print the set. Just I will discuss after this example. Put sort in the input loop and print the array. Okay, so this is one way. It's absolutely correct. Is there any another way? So there is one way which you can use set also here. So there are two ways. First is use set. So set by default sort each element at each insertion operation. And one more thing, you can use array also. You can use array also. And how? Let's say we have defined a vector, for example, vector of int. Okay, vector of int. Let's say it's a vector. Okay, then use a loop for I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. What you can do here, vec dot pushback that particular number. So let's say I have taken the input int x, c in x. So I have taken the input from the user and I have pushed that number into the vector. And after that, what you can do here, you can just sort it. Sort vec dot begin, comma vec dot end. Okay. Vec dot end. And now after that, what you can do here, you can just let's say the size equals to vec dot size, and after that for I equal for yeah, one more thing. So here I have used I, so never use I again in the nested loop. So use another variable name, because one student in Telegram has asked me, you know, he had did the same mistake. J equals to 0, j less than size comma j plus plus cout vec dot vec j. So this is one way of doing it, cout indel. So if you don't want to use set, then you can do like this also. So can you guys please tell me what is the time complexity of this solution? So if I'm going to do like this, then what would be my time complexity? Oh my god, there are lots of doubts. Sir, continue. Sir, how to print a set? Okay, I will discuss about it. We can sort the vector also. So I have sorted. So is there is there any problem? So n square log n. So Vikram has left, he has some work, so I will be taking class alone. N square log n. Okay, n square log n. And how n square log n? Can you just write on a chat box, anyone? How is the time complex? Sorry, order of n square time complexity, Arijit. By the way, it's not look like order of n square because you are using sorting function also. Okay, maybe it's n square. So just think about it. N square log n. And into time complexity of sort function. Yeah, the time complexity of sort function is order of n log n. Yeah, so the time complexity for this solution is order of n multiplication with n log of n and log n. So finally it's converted into order of n square log n. Because what happened actually here, you are doing this process n times, and for each time your time complexity is n log n to use the sort function, because sorting function takes n log n time complexity, and you are doing this process n times. So n into n log n, that is n square log n. Okay, and if you do the same process using set, then what would be your what will be your time complexity if you are using the exact same process using set? So just think about it. What will be your time complexity? Sorry, n cube log n. It's not n cube log n. How n cube log n? Because this is order of n log n, this is order of n. So overall, if you combine this complete process, so this is order of n log n. And this n log n process you are doing n times. So n into n log n, that is n square log n. So it's not n cube log n. Okay, so some student are saying that if you are using set, then the time complexity would be n log n. So let's see how. So what you will be doing, you will be defining a set of integers, then for I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, let's say I have taken the input int x, c in x, after that st dot infert x. And then just print it, print st, okay, print st. So this should be your code. Now this insertion operation takes order of log n, okay. But what happened here, to print the set, it will take order of n. So the overall time complexity is order of n square. So means order of log n and order of n. So the maximum value is order of n. So order of n multiplication with n times. So order of n square. But if you don't want to print it, then it will be n log n, because you are doing log n time n times. So n log n. But you have to print also. Sorry, you have to print it also. So the overall time complexity is order of n square. So you can see that the for this problem the set is it's the best option to use rather than using array or vector, because the time complexity is order of n square log n, and here the time complexity is order of n square, by the way. Okay, so if there are repeated element in a set, input and output would be incorrect. If they are repeated element, yeah, because set always store the element in unique, it always store the element uniquely, that's why. So there are one more container which also the do same process using for repeated element also, that is multi-set. I will discuss it later. Sir, in case of array there are another loop for printing, why we haven't considered it? Because what happened here, for the sort function this is the time complexity is n log n and log of n, okay, and to print the time complexity is order of n. So between order of n log n and order of n log n is it's more, that's why we have computed only n log n. Because if you do like this order of n log n plus order of n, so n log n is more than n order of n, that's why we haven't considered this, because we always go for worst case, that's why order of n log n, and we are doing the same process in order of in n time. So the overall time complexity is order of n square log n. By the way, there is one more important term, that the insertion of n element in set is order of it looks like order of n log n, but it's order of n actually. That is some mathematical terms which you will be know in future, but right now just consider it order of n log n to insert n elements in a set. Okay, is there any doubt till now? Now, yeah, so one student asks me about how to print the set. So this is the way to print this element in a set. Print elements in a set. So there is so in yesterday class we have discussed about iterators. So the syntax is like this: for auto it equals to st dot begin, comma it is not equals to st dot end, comma it plus plus cout star it. So this is the syntax to print n elements in a set. So just relate with for I equals to 0, I less than, and I plus plus. So in case of array or vector, we used to discuss. Sorry, we used to do like this: I equals to 0, I less than, and I plus plus, and cout vector of I. But in case of set, we do like this. In case of int, we have used auto. In place of I, we have used it. So this is your starting position, this is your ending position, and this is your it plus plus. Yeah. No doubt, sir. So let me tell you one more function which I just remember. That is find function. This function also used more often in set. Find function. So for example, if you want to find the position of a particular number in a set, for example, let's say your set look like this: 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 6 comma 7 comma 8. Okay, and if you want to find the iterator. Yeah, and by the way, in case of array and vector, we used to we more talk about indexes, that is 0 index or 1 index or 2 index. But in case of set, we talk more about iterators, pointers. Okay. So if you want to know the pointer of a particular number, so what the syntax is like this: auto it equals to st dot find and that number. For example, it's 6. Okay. So now what it will store? It will store the iterator position of the number 6 if it present in the set. So here we have present. So if you print c out, and to print a particular number we use star operator, star it. So it store the address, but when you dereference it using dereferencing operator, that is the star, so it will print the value of at that number. So if you print star it indel, so your output would be 6. And if the 6 is not present, then it will find for it will be if second case if 6 if 6 is not present, then it will be st.end. So if that particular number is present in a set, so it will store the address of that number, and if it doesn't present in the set, so it will store st.end. Yeah, I think it's more about array, sorry, set. You do only these things, not more than this, never. Sir, we can't access the set element using indexes. No. Indexing happens only in case of vector and array. For other than this, you can't use indexing. In case of set, we never use index. We can't use index because it's a, you know, it's a standard rule for C++. Okay, so is there any doubt? Otherwise, I'm going to discuss the next container. In case you have any little doubt, what will be the value of star it if the number is not present? So you runtime error, because if the number is not present, then it will be st.int, and you know st.int is the not even last element, last to last element means it is pointing to null, because in last class I have discussed that the iterator at this position would be begin plus n minus 1, and because you know when you go one extra position, so it is out of bound, so it is pointing to null. So if you dereference for null value, so it will show your runtime error. Sir, what is auto? So auto is a syntax which is used in case of iterator. For example, in case of integers we use int, but to store iterators we use auto. Sir, what is auto? So I have discussed what is auto. So auto is basically data type, you can say, to store the iterator value auto. So the, by the way, this is not a capital A, so this is a small a, but in Google Doc it automatically converts into capital A, so it's a small a. In set also this is small s. Okay. Sir, so this function can't be used to find a number in a set. Can be used to find a number in a set. You can do like this, you know, to find whether the element is present or not. So this is a question to find to check whether number is present or not in the set. So what you can do is like, so you can check like this: auto it equals to st dot find and that particular number. For example, let's say it's x. Okay, so you can check like this: if it equals to st.int, so if it equals to st.int, it means that the number is not present. Otherwise, if it is not equals to st.in, it means that number is present. So you can check like this also to check whether the number is present or not. No, it will not show the error if the number is not present. It will just point to ft.in. When you will dereference it using star IT operator, then it will show runtime error. It will show runtime error when you will dereference it, that is star IT operator. So here if you are using, so when it is ft.in and if you are using star IT, then it will show runtime error. Okay sir, so I think it's enough for set. I think it's more than enough. Okay, so now I am going to discuss map. So just look at the definition. Map is a special kind of STL container which store element as a key value pair. Okay, so and no two map values can have same key. For example, let's say for all the freshers, so just let me show you with an example. For all the freshers, all the freshers will be having a unique admission number. All the freshers will be having a unique admission number. Admission number, okay. All the freshers would be having a unique admission number. For example, let's say let me see on a name, that is Sakshi. So Sakshi, for example, has having 20 JE 0666. Let me see some more names. Saksham. So Saksham, for example, is having a 20J0667, for example, sorry, 648. Some more names, Shivali. Let's say she is having 20J0654. Let me see some more name, that is Mayank. Okay, by the way, it's fine, it's 3. So now, so you can relate like this. So this Sakshi, Saksham, Shivali, these are names actually. So these are key. So these are key and these are values. Okay, these are value. And no two mapped value can have same key. You know, no two admission number can have same name. For example, let's say there are two admission number 20J0648 and 20J0654. So each admission number will be having a unique name. Yeah. So if you talk about in case of key value pair, so it will be having like each value will be having a unique key. So this is written over here. No two mapped value can have same key. No two admission number can have same name. Okay, and how the syntax look like? The syntax would be like this. A map, your first data type, second data type. And the name of that map. So for example, I am using MP. So what you can do here, so MP of Sakshi equals to 20J0666, MP of Saksham, KSHAM, MP of Saksham equals to 20J0648, and the last one, that is MP of Shivali equals to, that is 20J0654. So it's like this. For each key you have a unique value. Okay, so this is the basic syntax of map, how map actually works. So the map, you know, the name itself suggests map. You are mapping something to something. For example, in case of functions, which you just learn in your 12th class. So map, what happened is map for each input a particular output. Okay, so in case of function, if a trigonometric function or any kind of function, so it's map between input and output. So it's exactly similar to that function mapping. So for each name we are mapping with a particular dimension number, for each key we are mapping with a particular value. So it's a key value pair. Okay, and one more thing, all the names is sorted in ascending order also. So just let me out right here, all the keys are sorted in ascending order. In ascending order, all the keys are sorted in ascending order. Okay, so if you have any doubt till now, so just ask on the chat box, otherwise I will proceed further. Is erase functions there for vector? No, erase function is not present in vector. So erase function only present in set. Can we delete a particular element in a vector? No, we can't delete a particular element in a vector. So we don't have any functions to delete a particular element in a vector. Yeah, but we can delete the last element of a vector using popback function. But there is no function to delete any particular element in a vector. So basically it is 1-to-1 mapping, right? Yeah, it's a 1-to-1 mapping. By the way, I don't remember 1-to-1 exactly, but yeah, if you can relate like this, it's a 1-to-1 mapping. For each particular input, we have a particular output. Sir, can two different key have same value? Yeah, two different key may have same value. For example, for two different key, we have same value. Yeah. By the way, this doesn't happen in case of our college for admission number, but in case of map, two note. So let me write on a note. Two different keys may have same values. It's fine. Yeah. So. Sir, can two keys have same values? Sir, two keys can. Yeah, it can. Sir, if both the key and value are string, then how will they be sorted? So let me show with an example. So for example, we have a. So in case of this example, how the map look like? So the if internal structure of map would be like this. It would look like this. So we have key. That is okay. So if you sort in ascending order, so the first name would be SAKHH. So so basically this is sorted actually. So if you sort alphabetically, so this would come at first position, this would come at second position, and this would come at third position. So it will look like this. Sakshi, this is key, and this is your value. And then we have Saksham. So the dot 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 dot. So let me write this completely. Saksham 20J0648. Okay, and the rest one would be like this. So it will be sorted in as a key. So it will be sorted according to key. So let me show you with an example of integer. So it would be more. Clear to all of you. So we have for example, we have defined a map of integer to let's say int to int map mp, and we have mp of, so let me show that is the second argument is a string. So mp of 1 equals to capital A, mp of 2 equals to capital B. Yeah, so you will be facing lots of problem when you have to map something to something. For example, here means I am mapping 1 to A, 2 to B, and MP of 3 equals to C. So this is the example of integer to string mapping. This could also be like this, map of string to integer MP. So it will look MP of, for example, MP of A to 1. By the way, this is a string, so you can also write a bunch of different characters like this. By the way, let me show you an easier one. Let's say this is your char, okay, and everything is in single inverted comma. This is your A, this is your B, and this is your C. This is your B and this is your C, and exactly same thing you can do like here also. MP of character A equals to 1, MP of character B equals to 2, and dot 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 dot. So I think in is there any doubt till now? Sorry, both the key and value are. Is there any doubt till now? Am I audible or not? So I am not audible. Oh, okay. I thought that I am not audible. Okay. So I think map is clear. So we have some functions in map also. So whenever you face some problem using functions, so you can just go to this site, that is C++ reference. So you can just look at map. So just write on a map. Sorry, map. Just wait a minute. So see, there are lots of functions that we have: C begin, C in, count function, erase function, find function, lower bound, upper bound, size function. So there are lots of functions map have actually, okay, and there are lots of documentation for any particular container. So you may go through all of this, but not it's mandatory. So just go through some important function which you used, that is find function, erase function, and all this. So just let me show with some functions that is important, that is size function. Size function, so you can write like this: int n equals to mp dot size. So we have some erase function. Erase function, so you can write like, sorry, yeah, so the syntax is like this: mp dot erase, and now you have to pass that particular key which you want to delete, because we know that all the key are unique. Let me write here: all the keys are unique, all the keys are unique. So just pass that particular key, so it will delete that particular key. And the time complexity for this is order of log n also, because all the keys are stored in ascending order. This is your order of 1. Yeah. So we access a particular element in a map by its key. You have to access the element using key, MP of that particular key. So if you write MP of, so if you are writing like this, MP of a particular key, so it will show you that value. If it is present in a map, if it is not, means if the key is present in a map, so it will show you value. But if not present, that key, then it will show some random value. That will be some random value, means it is not fixed actually. But one more thing, but in case of so it will be random. But if in case of array, in case of integer, so if you are accessing a integer that is not present, so the default value would be, so the default value is 0 for integer, but not for all the cases. So it's completed, map also completed. So by the way, it's so theoretical. So maybe somebody don't like it. So we have lots of functions. We can go. You can go through it. You can use some functions also. But I will write on Google Doc that which functions are important after the class. So you can go through all this. And to know the syntax, you can go through this site. This is a very important site. I mean, all the C++ containers are present here. So you can go through each and every. So is there any doubt or I should proceed next? So if you have any doubt, just write on a chat box. Otherwise, just write no doubt, sir. Otherwise, then only I'll be able to know that is there any doubt or not. Sir, please share the link in Google Doc. Please share the link in Google Doc. Okay. So this is the Control C. So this is for map. One minute. Why it is not in blue color? Yeah. No doubt, sir. It's fine. So should I proceed for next container or should we solve some problems? Because maybe it's kind of boring because it's so theoretical. So just write on the chat box whether I should go for next container or should I go for some problems. Problems, other ones, problems. Okay, all the students are talking about problems. Okay, so let's go with some problems. By the way, I haven't taken any problem, so let me just see. So just give me 1 minute to search this problem. I think it is better to, if you guys have any problem which you want to discuss, then just write on a chat box. So if you guys have faced any problem, face any difficulties, any problem which you have practiced, so you can ask on a chat box. I will discuss that. Because I have lots of problems, so if you, means it would be better that if you guys have any doubt, then I will clear that using that problem. So, have you faced any problem? Or it's fine for all of you? It's fine, then I will be giving any one problem from HackerRank. But if you have any problem, then just paste on a chat box the link of that problem. I will discuss that. HackerRank. Printing 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Sir, is there any tuple in C++? Yeah, so we have tuple in C++. But very rarely use we tuple in C++. That's why I haven't discussed. But I may discuss if you guys want. But we very rarely use tuple. So there is one student who is asking a problem to print 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So you guys just take 1 minute or 2 minute to think about this problem. How do we print 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4? Okay, so the problem statement is like this. So I will discuss this problem. So the question is print like this 1, 1 for 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, dot 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 dot. I think it's very easy problem. It will take hardly 1 or 2 minutes. So just take one minute to solve, to think about it. In the next line, sir. Okay, it's fine. One comma two comma three comma four, one comma two comma three comma four, one comma two comma three comma four comma five, like this. So it should look like this. Okay, so I think you guys have tried it. So let me just write on a code. So what happened? In first line you have to print only one. In second line you have to print only 1 and 2. In third line you have to print 1, 2, 3. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just follow some, you know, some rule which is happening again and again. So you can just look at here that in the first line you have to print only one number. In second line you have to print two numbers. In third you have to print three numbers. So what you can do here, for I equals to 1, I less than or equals to n, comma I plus plus. I mean I am going for each row. So for in, for this, for first row, for first row your I equals to 1. Okay, for second row your I equals to 2. For third row I equals to 3. And for fourth row I equals to 4. And for the last row, that is 5, I equals to 5. Okay, so what happened here? So for j equals to 1, j is less than or equal to I comma j plus plus, just print that number, that is j. After this, after that, cout indel. Yeah, so this is your code for this problem. I am going for each row, and for each row I am printing the content for that row. For I equals to 4, you have to print 1, 2, 3, 4. For 5, you have to print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Make two loops. Use nested loop. You can use set here also. But there is no need to use set. You know, don't unnecessarily use all these things. Because there are lots of simple things. Just go through two loops. That's why no need to use go through loop, set and all, but you can use it. I mean, so is there any another problem, sir? Mirror of a triangle. Oh, like this. This your I got it. I think it will take some time. That's why it's a practice problem, so you can just think about it. So let me give some problem to you. Solve. Let's go through some easy problems. Staircase minimax problem. Time grading student. What is this minimax problem? Given 5 positive integers, find the minimum and maximum value that can be calculated by summing exactly 4 and 4. If you guys have any problem, then just this is spiral printing. I don't want to discuss this kind of problem, spiral, because I want to discuss, you know, some standard problem like which you're sorting and all these things, because you will revise all these functions that I have discussed, sort function. You know, in case of a spiral, it's just a thinking kind of question. You have to think about a solution and just go through it. So it will take only loops and all. But I want to discuss the problem which require a sorting, you know, just the Vikram which Vikram had discussed earlier. The problem which required a pair, a sort function and some kind of while loop also. So I want to discuss that kind of problem. That's why I don't want to discuss this spiral problem. But it's good to practice all these questions. It's fine. A magic square. I think magic square is good enough to discuss. Let me see, is any problem which I have sent me. So this is the problem which I have sent me. Okay. So just go through this problem. So I have so I'm going to share this link. Why the students are so less? Only 44 students. Sir, where we find problems on STL? We would share some problems in STL, don't worry. सो रहे हैं उनको ये भी लगता होगा कि सब रिकॉर्डेड तो होगा ही यूट्यूब पे, तो बाद में देख लेंगे. बट आना चाहिए यार, हमें भी अच्छा लगता है, बिकॉज मतलब हमें कुछ मिलता थोड़ी ना है पढ़ा के. बस हम लोग पढ़ाते हैं इंटरेस्ट के लिए. तो अब आप ही लोग इंटरेस्ट नहीं दिखाओगे तो फिर हमारा भी मन नहीं करेगा, तो हम भी नहीं आएंगे. तो मतलब ऐसा कुछ ऐसा नहीं है कि मतलब टीचर नहीं ना है हम लोग, जैसे आप लोग को पढ़ा टीचर्स प्रोफेसर्स पढ़ाते हैं. हम भी तो स्टूडेंट ही है, आपसे 2 साल ही बड़े हैं. आप फर्स्ट ईयर के हो, हम थर्ड ईयर के हैं. सो आया करो यार, हमें भी अच्छा लगता है. मतलब इंटरेस्ट के लिए ही आते हैं. अब आप लोग इंटरेस्ट नहीं दिखाओगे तो फिर हमारा भी मन नहीं करेगा, फिर होता है ना, फिर समझ रहे होगे मैं क्या बोलना चाहता हूँ. तो आया करो, बोल दिया करो ग्रुप पे कि अगर ऐसा ही रहा फिर तो हम लोग यूट्यूब पे क्लास ही नहीं लेंगे, फिर हम लोग गूगल मीट पे या माइक्रोसॉफ्ट मीट पे लेंगे. तब ज़्यादा स्ट्रेंथ होती है, 200-300 स्ट्रेंथ होती है, बिकॉज तब उनको ऐसा लगता है ना कि रिकॉर्डेड नहीं रहेगा तो आना ही पड़ेगा. सर आप दोनों बहुत अच्छा पढ़ाते हो, थैंक्स. हमें भी नहीं पता था अच्छा पढ़ाते हैं. ट्राई करते हैं अच्छा पढ़ाने का, और क्या. मतलब हम भी, बाय द वे हम भी फर्स्ट टाइम ही पढ़ा रहे हैं ऐसा वर्चुअल. बाय द वे हम लोग कभी पढ़ाए नहीं थे इसके पहले. तो ऐसा होता है ना कि जब आप लोग अभी फर्स्ट ईयर में हो, जब आप लोग थर्ड ईयर में जाओगे तो आप लोग का रिक्रूटमेंट होगा. तो कोड आइसम के जो सीनियर्स होंगे आपके, जस्ट जो 1 साल जस्ट बड़े होंगे, वो आपका इंटरव्यू लेंगे टू सेलेक्ट इन कोड आइसम. सो ऐसे ही होता है रिक्रूटमेंट. सो हम भी फर्स्ट टाइम ही पढ़ा रहे हैं, फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस है हमारा ऐसे वर्चुअली पढ़ाने का. ट्राई करते हैं अच्छा पढ़ाने का. बाकी पता ही है कभी हर सब चीज़ मन से नहीं हो पाता, बट या वी ट्राइड आवर बेस्ट. सर कैन यू प्लीज सजेस्ट अ बुक फॉर रेफरेंस टू लर्न ओनली सी प्रोग्रामिंग? यू कैन गो थ्रू सम बुक्स, दैट इज लेट अस सी. बट I would not recommend to go through book because it takes lots of time to, you know, to learn a simple things. But if you are a, you know, if you are a book bookies, means if you love to read books, then you can go through a book that is latest C to learn C and C++. And for competitive programming, there are some PDF of the book. I will share the link of that PDF to know some more about data structures and algorithms. I will share in a Telegram group, don't worry, after taking the class. CSC में होना जरूरी है कोड आइसम के लिए? ऐसा हमारे लिए नहीं है, बट ऐसा होता है ना कि कॉलेज में मतलब अलाउ नहीं होता कि नॉन CSC वालों को. बट हम लोग अलाउ कर देते हैं कि ठीक है कोई भी क्लास कर सकता है, बट ऑफिशियली ऐसा कुछ रूल नहीं है. इसीलिए हम लोग थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम होता है नॉन CSC वालों को रिक्रूट करना. क्लास करने में तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, आप कोई भी क्लास कर सकते हो, चाहे वो किसी भी ब्रांच का हो, माइनिंग हो, माइनिंग मशीनरी हो, मैकेनिकल हो, इलेक्ट्रिकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, कोई भी ब्रांच हो आप क्लास कर सकते हो. रिक्रूटमेंट में शायद थोड़ा हो सकता है, आई डोंट नो एग्जैक्टली, बट मे बी होता होगा, हमें नहीं पता. बट हम तो CSC के ही हैं, तो हमें हमारा हो गया था इंटरव्यू अच्छे से. या सो विक्रम इज बैक, सो विक्रम शेयर कर देगा. ओके, बाय द वे सब लोगों ने प्रॉब्लम पढ़ा या नहीं जो मैंने दिया हुआ था, कि सब ऐसे ही कहानी सुन रहे हैं मेरा. सो आई हैव शेयर्ड अ प्रॉब्लम, जस्ट रीड इट, एंड इफ यू हैव कम अप विद दिस एनी काइंड ऑफ सॉल्यूशन देन जस्ट राइट ऑन अ चैट बॉक्स. otherwise then I will discuss it. Yes, sir, trying and out. Okay, thoda socho. और एक बार क्लास में बोल देना आप लोग, मतलब आप लोग ग्रुप, अपना जो ग्रुप होगा तो बोल देना कि जिनको भी क्लास करना हो वो किया करें, ऐसे मिस करोगे तो फिर होता है ना, हमारा भी धीरे धीरे इंटरेस्ट थोड़ा कम होगा। बट हम ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए, बट मैं समझता हूँ थोड़ा क्वीज है तो लोड हो सकता है, चिल है, तो नेक्स्ट क्लास से देखेंगे कि अगर स्ट्रेंथ बढ़ी तो बेटर है आप लोगों के लिए, हमारा भी इंटरेस्ट रहता है तो अच्छा लगता है पढ़ाने में। अब बताओ, मतलब फर्स्ट क्लास में 300 के आसपास इंट्री स्ट्रेंथ थी, अभी 50 भी नहीं है, तो ज़्यादा डिफरेंस है ना। थोड़ी बहुत होती तो उतना लोड ना होता, बट 300 से 50 पे आना, 44 पे आना इवन, सो यू नो इट डिजास्ट्रस काइंड ऑफ। सो इसीलिए ट्राई करना कि स्ट्रेंथ बढ़े थोड़ी, बिकॉज आप फर्स्ट ईयर हो यार, इवन सेकेंड ईयर की स्ट्रेंथ थोड़ी ज़्यादा है आपसे। सो आप लोग ट्राई करो कि क्लास अटेंड किया करो। दो ऑल द सेशंस आर रिकॉर्डेड ऑन यूट्यूब, बट इट्स यू नो इट्स रिकमेंडेड टू टेक द लाइव क्लासेस बिकॉज योर डाउट वुड बी क्लियर हियर इटसेल्फ। सो दैट्स हाउ यू वी से दैट जस्ट टेक ऑल द लाइव क्लासेस। नेक्स्ट क्लास से हो सकती है वो हम लोग देख लेंगे, बट डोंट वरी अबाउट इट। ओके, सो सम स्टूडेंट्स आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम। जस्ट टेक लास्ट मिनट, देन आई विल डिस्कस इट। ओके, सो आई थिंक द प्रॉब्लम इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू, सो लेट मी डिस्कस इट नाउ। सो लेट मी सी सम सॉल्यूशन इन द चैट बॉक्स दैट विद व्हाट यू गाइस आर थिंकिंग अबाउट दिस सॉल्यूशन। सॉर्ट इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर एंड पुट द लूप फॉर 2 to the पावर एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन। मयंक, या इट्स करेक्ट सर, जो क्वेश्चन करते हैं हैकर रैंक में तो उसमें बहुत कुछ लिखा रहता है ऑलरेडी, तो उसको अलग करके नया लिखे क्या? इट्स अप टू यू, आई मीन इफ यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू यूज ऑल दिस, बाई द वे इट्स रिकमेंडेड डोंट टच एनी थिंग बिकॉज यू हैव टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम इन दिस फंक्शन, सो जस्ट लीव एज इट इज एवरी थिंग। सो जस्ट राइट योर सोल्यूशन ओवर हियर इन दिस फंक्शन इट सेल्फ, डोंट रिमूव एनी थिंग इन हैकर रैंक। नेक्स्ट क्लासेस होगी, क्विजेस है, वी वुड लेट यू नो अबाउट द क्लासेस टाइमिंग, सो डोंट वरी सर। कैलोरीज को डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर में सॉर्ट करके माइल्स कैलकुलेट करेंगे, इट्स फाइन। सो लेट मी डिस्कस इट नाउ। सो द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट इज एक्चुअली, इफ यू आर टेकिंग अ जे कपकेक्स एंड ऑफ सी कैलोरी, सो यू हैव टू गो यू नो यू हैव टू वॉक 2 to the पावर जे मल्टीप्लीकेशन विथ सी। ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल हियर वी हैव 5, 10 and 7, सो फॉर द फर्स्ट वन यू विड गो थ्रू 2 to the पावर जे दैट इज 0, 2 to the पावर 0 मल्टीप्लीकेशन विथ, सॉरी 2 to the पावर 0 मल्टीप्लीकेशन विथ 5, देन 2 to the पावर 1 मल्टीप्लीकेशन विथ 10, देन 2 to the पावर 2 मल्टीप्लीकेशन विथ 7। सो यू नो टू टू सम ऑल दोज नंबर्स टू अ पर्टिकुलर मिनिमम नंबर, एम आई ऑडिबल? So just wait a minute, my data got exhausted completely. So just wait a minute, I'm gonna change the mobile phone. Just wait a minute. Sorry. Just wait a minute. Am I audible now? Why the students have left? Okay, sorry, it got disconnected. And all the students had thought that the class is over. Because my data got exhausted, 1.5 GB. That's why. Sorry. Okay. So can you just write on a chat box that the classes are is held now? Because sorry for that interruption. So maybe they were trying to reconnect. Okay. So just wait a minute. Then I will discuss about a solution. Because I have to, I am recording as well as using a mobile phone also. So that's why my data got exhausted completely. So I've changed my phone. But in the next class, I will, I will take care of this. So 37 students. So earlier it was 44 around. Okay. So let me discuss the solution now. So, you have to multiply 2 to the power I multiplication with j. So what happened? So 2 to the power 0 is 1, then 2 to the power 1 is 2, then 2 to the power 2 is 4. So 1, 2, 4, 8. So these are constant. You have to multiply these numbers with a particular number that would present in the array. So for example, let's say at first position we have a number that is a1, then a2, then a3, then a4, then a5. So your final answer would be a1 plus 2 times a2, then 4 times a3, then 8 times a4, then 16 times a5. So you know this 1, 2, 3, 4, these are constant value, but you can change this a1, a2, a3, a4 in such a way that your sum of these number is minimum. So you have to minimize this number, minimize this sum. So you have to minimize this sum, and write on a chat box that how to minimize this, how to minimize this expression, minimize this expression. So you have to minimize this expression, that is a1 plus 2 times a2 plus 3 times a3, then 4 times a4, like this. Yes sir, you are audible. Okay, so first descending order and then multiply. Yeah, because you know these constant terms are 1, 2, 3, 4, this is constant value. So you have to rearrange a1, a2, a3, a4 in such a way that the sum is minimum. So what you can do here, so just put the maximum number over here, then the next you know, this thus the smaller number at second position, then the next smaller number at third position. I mean to say that sort the array in descending order. So for example, so let me show with an example. So let's say we have an array of 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is your ascending order, and some random distribution, for example 2, 1, and 3. This is some random distribution, and in descending order we have 3, 2, 1. So this is in descending order, descending order. Okay, so just tell me what would be the sum in all the three cases, ascending order. So if you follow the arrangement of the number like this, 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 then what would be your sum of this expression? So just write on a chat box that what would be answer in all three cases when you sort the array in ascending order, and if you sort the array in any random function, if for in any random distribution and in descending order, then what would be your you know, answer in all three cases? Sakshi Mishra, even A2 should be in descending order. Yeah, it's fine, it's a final solution, but I am asking about what would be value if you follow this arrangement of the array, that is 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, and 3, 2, 1. So in ascending order, it would be 1 times 1 plus 2 times 2 plus 4 times 3. That is 17, I guess. Yeah. In case of random distribution, it will be 4 plus, that is 16. Okay, and in case of ascending order, it will be 3 plus 4, that is 7, 7 plus 4, that is 11. So you can see, 17, 16, and 11. So you can see that the answer is, means we are getting the minimum answer when you follow descending order of the array. So to find the minimum value of this expression, just sort the array in descending order. Okay, so this is the solution actually. So what we can do here, to write the solution, so I'm going to write the solution. So is it clear, the solution is clear or not? The solution is clear, not odd actually. I think you guys are some 1 minute lag, so just come on to live class. Yes sir, solution is clear. Divya, Saksham, Uma Shankar, Arijit, yeah, so solution is clear. So just let me write here. So you will be given a vector of calories. So just first of all, find the size of that vector using size function, that is calories dot size and calories e. Calories dot size and int answer equals to 0. So I have initialized my answer. Sorry, yeah. So you can see that the return type is long. So just use long here. So for I equals to 0, so first of all, you have to sort in descending order. So how do we sort it? First, sort in ascending order using sort function. Sort. So let me change. Copy it. Calories dot begin comma calories dot end, after that calories dot end, then reverse calories dot begin comma calories dot end. Okay, so we have sorted in descending order, and after that for I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So yeah, so to find the value of power function, power of 2 to the power I, so there is a function, that is power function. So you can, so it's a inbuilt C++, you can check take it. So int current value equals to power function of 2 to the power I multiplication with calorie of I, and n for plus equals to current value, and finally just return that, return answer. So just run the code. So I is up to so we have, so test cases are passed. So let me see, is there any overflow error? There might be overflow. So just type cost it to long, yeah. So run it. So we have passed both the test cases. So let me submit it. Okay. So can anybody tell me that why the two test cases are not passed, even though my solution is correct, why the two cases are failed? What is type cost? I will discuss it. So overflow, yeah. So this is the problem of overflow, because you know, you have to you know, n is up to 40, so it might possible that you have to calculate the value of 2 to the power 40, and you know, 2 to the power 40 is a very 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 large number. You can't even store it so in integer, because integer is stored only because the capacity of integer is 32 bit, so you can store only 2 to the power 32 numbers, but here it is possible to store 2 to the power 40 number. So 2 to the power 40 we can't store 2 to the power 40 in integer or long. So this is the problem of overflow. So that's why my two test cases got failed. So how do we how can we change it? We can change like this. So always look at the constraint, because it's very important to, you know, to look at the constraint, that what is the maximum worst case value of n. So how you can change it? So you can, instead of using long, you can use long int n for equals to 0. What we can do here, so instead of int you can use long. So our solution is absolutely correct, but the problem arises due to this overflow. So let me see. Yeah, so all the test cases got passed. So what I changed actually here, so earlier I was using integer, here I was using integer, but you know, integer can't store more than 2 to the power 32, because in our case it is possible that the n is up to 40, so it might possible that we have to store 2 to the power 40 multiplication with something. So just change int to long int. So I intentionally use int because I knew that it will not pass all the test cases, but I wanted to show you that what overflow actually. So this is the problem of overflow. So I have changed int to long. So now my solution got passed completely, all the test cases got passed. So always take care of these things, long, int. Okay, so I have completed this problem. Is there any doubt in this problem? Please show code window. So this is the code actually, a small code. Don't look at all these things. These are it's written by HackerRank. So just look at this solution. This is your important solution. So is there any doubt till now? No sir. I don't know why there is no doubt. Now I am having doubt that why you guys don't have any doubt. Okay, so it's fine. So so do you have quizzes or should I continue? Because Chirag told me that first years have quiz from 11. So you guys have quiz or not? So I discuss typecasting. Okay, so let me discuss typecasting, what actually typecasting is. So just let me show with an example. So first of all, let me just write this code on the Google Doc. let me share the link of this problem. Sorry, this is the link of the problem. Okay, so this is the last because I have some issues, I don't know what, but so this is the last, that is typecasting. So the typecasting is, let's say we have declared a character variable that is char c that is equals to a, and if you want to print the c values, so let's see what is your output. So see, the output is A, but if you want to know the ASCII value, that is the integer value, so what you can do here, int value equals to, int value equals to, you know, just typecast it, int value of C. So now let's see what is the value of C. So this is typecasting actually. We are taking the integer value of that character. So the ASCII value of A is 65. So if you required ASCII value for any character, so you can use like this. So this is the typecasting. So I have typecast that character to an integer value. So this is the way how we typecast it. And typecasting happens in so many places, in so many problems. So this is the basic example of typecasting. We have declared a character and we have stored the value of A, and if you want to know the value of ASCII value of that character, so just typecast it to integer. So this is the only way to know ASCII value, just typecast it. So this is the basic example of this ASCII value. So you guys want to leave because maybe there is some problem. I think it's 2-hour class today, but in next class I will take care of all these things, whatever happened today. I'm sorry for this interruption. Okay, do you guys have any doubt? So just write on the chat box, and if you don't have any doubt, so you may leave, because I'm not going to discuss any next topic. I will just clear your doubts if you guys have any doubt. No doubt. No sir, thank you. No doubt sir, okay. So if you don't have any doubt, so you may leave. Thanks for today. I don't know why you are there are some problems. I think I should say sorry for that, but yeah. No doubt sir, thank you. Okay, so if you don't have any doubt, you may leave, and if you have any doubt, just write on the chat box, I will clear it. When we use map in programming, so it depends on problem, requirement of the problem. If you found that you can map in this problem, so you may use it. But the important point is that you should know at least what is map, how it works. So it depends upon problem, you know. And you know, your map is used in so many problems, let me tell you. I have, you know, when I started coding, then in earlier I used to solve only using map. I never use array and all, because I love map, but not always it's the case. But map is used in so many places, in so many problems. When you will be practicing on Code Sources and other HackerRank, then only you would be able to know. It's not like any rule that how to use and where to use. You should know how to use, and to know where to use, you should practice a lot. Sir, once again explain this last one. Okay, so this one, this typecasting. So the typecasting basically, so first of all I have declared a character, character, and I have stored that is A in that character variable. So when we print that variable, so see the content of C is A. But if you want to know the ASCII value of that variable, ASCII value of that particular character, so what I have done here, I have just typecasted it to integer value. So what it does, it changes that character to an integer value, and I have stored in this variable and I have printed it. So see, the value of character is SI value of character A is 65.
Yeah.
And if you change it to small a, then let's see what is the SI value of C. So see, the SI value of small a is 97. So this is the SI value of character. Please give some question in group. Yeah, we will see a lots of problem in the group today, because right now we have covered map, sort as well. So we will share some problem. So it's a ASCII, A-S-C-I-E-E, ASCII value. So for each character we have a particular ASCII value which is given. For capital A, we have small a we have 97, for small b we have 98, and dot like this. So you know, it's a kind of key value player. You may read it like this. So this is your key and this is your value. So this is a key value player like this. For small a we have 97 ASCII value. So just let me copy paste it on a Google Doc. Okay, thank you sir. Okay, so still there are 20 students. So do you guys have any doubt? If you guys don't have any doubt, so I think we should stop the screening now. I should stop the stream now if you guys don't have any doubt. When we use math in programming, so it depends upon problem. When you will practice a lot, then you will able to know it better where to use. Sir, question in a group. So yeah, so we will discuss questions in a group, don't worry. So now I'm going to stop this streaming now. Okay, so bye.